This is my battle against Norman of Petalburg, and this is the fifth gym in Grezzy's Emerald Adventure. Now, today, it's just literally straight in, because it's a long battle, and I don't want to split it into two parts. And I'm drastically under-leveled here, with a level 30, level 28, and two level 27s, and a HM slave at level 3, and an egg. Gave it a quick claw just to make it that bit faster. Better give it my best shot. Yep. Now the first Pokemon he's likely to send out is a Spinda. Now Spinders are a pain. Knock them out as fast as you can because they have a move called Teeter Dance. I wouldn't recommend trying to poison any of his Pokemon or burn them or freeze them, as if they used up their Teeter Dance, confuses you. But if you try and do that, it boosts their power for Cade, which is, well, it hurts a lot, because I tried it in a previous battle where paralyzing, yeah, it's fine. But I wouldn't recommend paralysing stuff like Spinder, because you can usually outspeed them. It's only stuff like the Linoone that's coming out and stuff like that that just gets quite annoying. So, use his Facade. Oh my god, it's quite long away, this Pokemon, so hurt in its confusion. 4 hit points, Facade, yep, you're gone. So that's a real pain because I've lost my best Pokemon already. Now I am going to send out Lecky, the Mayonetric, and we are just going to go for it straight with a Spark. Physical based attack, I think. Yeah, and that's enough with a critical hit to knock that Spinder out. You've got to plan your strategies with gym leaders and find out what you're using. Otherwise you're going to get yourself in a real pickle, and I wouldn't recommend it. Now, Vigoroth. It's an incredibly fast Pokemon, and it has quite a high attack. So you paralyze it to slow it down. So you can get the first hit with powerful moves, and that just stops it from being paralyzed and whatnot. Quick attack. I'm just trying to get it low enough. Oh, slash, that hurts. Critical hits, and that's what it's good for. So be careful with that. Now I'm going to send out my mighty animal called Charlie. So that's paralyzed, and its Intimidator cuts its attack. So that works in my favor. I'm going to use Bite now and hope it will flinch. Oh no. Yeah, but he's going to use a potion or something. So in this time, you know, in this bit when they're down that far, you can use potions and stuff, because it's pointless attacking them again, because it's just going to heal themselves and you're only going to be back where you essentially started. So I'm going to use another revive to bring back Lecky and Grezzly at halfway, and because it's paralyzed, it has a high chance it can't move. So use super potion now and use that on Grezzly just to bring it up to health, and uses Facade, yep, critical hit because it's paralyzed, and that's Bite makes it flinch. So if it's a Pokemon flinches, it can't. And I think I've really critical hit, that's good. Vigoroth's out of the way, and we've got level 28 now, so that just boosts its stats up a bit and makes it a bit stronger. Now, the next Pokemon he's likely to send out will be a Linoone, but he isn't. He's going to send out a Linoone. No, he isn't. He's going to send out a Slaking, sorry. So we're going to send out Grezzly first. Slakings are incredibly strong, but there's only one downside. There's a downside for them being on your team. They can only attack once every two turns because they loaf around. Same with Slakoth. Slakoth. Same with that. So we're going to Thunder Wave it to slow it down. and then so it's paralyzed, and that means it can't move. I'm going to use spark and just keep hitting it with it. It doesn't do anything, and counter won't work because it isn't like a close thing. Like if you use mega punch, it could counter that, but it has to be like that kind of thing. It's paralyzed. Shall I risk it? Shall I go for another spark? Yeah, and it has a berry. It has a citrus berry. When it goes under 1/3 of its hit points to restore 1/4 of them, which is a lot. It's 25% actually of its hit points it restores, which is 1/4. Oh no! Should have been a bit more. Oh fuck, hey. Yep, it's gone level 27 and it's out. Now we're gonna have to send out Grizzly. And it will use a potion or something this round. So, just gonna use the hyper potion, which restores 200 hit points. So, we're just gonna attack it with a mud shot and keep. Doesn't do as much as spark, but we've lowered its speed even further. That means. Yeah. Now, these items are quite handy. X attacks. And X defense. I got the idea from Maryland, who's a great video person who on YouTube. I suggest you check him out because he uses X attack items to increase attack, and they're quite good because look, see how much considering amount of damage that has done now, which and it loafs around. So we'll use a water gun just to try and get it. So if we use mud shot, it wouldn't put it in the red again. So we'll use a mud shot attack. Which takes it down, takes it down a bit more, which is quite useful. It's loafing around still. So we'll use Mud Shot. Please get a critical hit. Yeah, it's in the red, but he's already used a potion, so hopefully he won't do it. He's used Facade now, which knocks me out. Great. So we're left with, Barret, the Aron. Use Headbutt. So, oh god, it's loafing around. What should we do? Use takedown, takedown, it's a bit more powerful, but we get recoil. Oh, it's on literally one hit point. Use his counter. Oh, don't like that. And slacking's gone. So, that's a big one out of the way. Barret gets tons of experience points. Now, his Linoon. That has a really big weakness as well. And if you're wondering why I'm sending out a Zigzagoon, it's because I don't want Barret to get knocked out because I'm going to use Revive on something. Just makes it a bit easy. Which makes it a bit easier for me. And restore. Use Grizzly. Slash. High chance of critical to hit. Which is bad. It's really bad, folks. So don't do it. So we'll send out Barret now. And hopefully this will just weaken it. Headbutt or takedown. Use takedown. It's facade. It'll probably knock it out though. Oh, critical hit. That's good. Not very effective. It's even better. Oh, god, it's tap missed. Let's use another revive in this space then to bring back Lecky. Store 41 points slash. That'll knock it out easy. Oh, no, it won't actually. God, this Barret's got guts. This Aron's got guts. So. We just do the headbutt. Yeah, that should knock it out. Critical hit. What a surprise. Now. So it's fainted. And we're going to send out Lecky now. We're going to send out Lecky. Because we're going to use Thunder Wave on it. Belly Drum. This cuts its HP. And it maximises attack. But, as I said, it loses its HP. And it doesn't have a berry on. And then you reduce its speed, and then you attack it, and hope you get a critical hit. And then Lecky's gone. And we've got Grizzly on half hit points. Now, this is the risky bit. Shall you? Yep, we'll win this. And we've got a fifth gym badge, so how about that? Which is quite useful. Because it means we're going to challenge the sixth gym next. You lost to D.V, your own son. No! It's a father's worst dream, losing to his son. Nah, I'm only joking. But we've got the balance badge. So, that's quite useful. because it means we can use the new HM Surf, which we'll be getting in a few minutes, well, in the next part actually, because I'm running a bit short on time. And then, well, next part, I don't know what we're going to do. Should we just go out and try some surfing? I think that'll probably be best. Anyway, join us next time, folks, as I don't know what we're going to do.